Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm lucky enough to be on a Ducati Multistrada. So here we go. So I'm going to start out by thanking Robb at Steele Recreation here in Bridgewater. He arranged for me to take this beautiful Ducati Multistrada out for a road ride review today. This is the first Ducati I've ever been on. I believe these are a four-cylinder. Motorcycle. And as soon as you look at these, you can tell they are definitely a premium motorcycle. You could say they are Ducati's answer to BMW's GS line. I've never ridden the GS 1250s or their new 1300s. But many say that these are the answer to it. So currently, these bikes have a multitude of riding modes. Currently I'm just in touring mode. Suspension is full electronic suspension. Suspension is set to auto right now. So the bike will adjust the suspension according to the mode that you are in. And I assume the speeds and terrain that you are on. Really nice TFT display on these, really easy to see. It's a bright sunny day, no problem at all seeing it. I'm not sure the size, I'm gonna guess that it's at least 6, probably 7 inch TFT display. Windshield, one hand adjustable. Up and down when you move, that's fantastic. So I believe these bikes are a little over 500 pounds, which when you think about it, for a larger four-cylinder bike is really quite reasonable. It handles quite well. Feels good to ride for a bit heavier of a bike. Very comfortable. Seat feels fantastic. It's quite wide up front. I would say really good really good wind protection. One really good feature that I like, Robb was showing me before I'd taken the bike out, is down below, just forward of your knees, there's almost some sort of, I don't know what you would call it, a vent or wind foil that you can open up and close. So you close it and it will, I don't know if you close it or open it, but whatever it does is it'll direct wind, or it will direct engine from the heat on your legs for when it's cold out. You open it when it's warm, or vice versa, but you can direct heat from the engine on your legs for cold weather. Thought that was kind of a neat, neat feature. The electronics package on these Ducatis is probably second to none. I mean, full electronics, riding modes, suspension package, full electronic adjustable suspension. Definitely a premium motorcycle. Pleasure to ride. We're gonna go out here and get on a 100 series highway and see how it feels with a bit more wind coming on you. Yeah, these things have all kinds of power. I was just out on a 100 series highway. Great wind protection, incredible power. All kinds of electronics, as I said before. There's, you know, wheelie control, traction control, ABS. And it's all really well working. You know, it's not like the traction control of my Transalp that is just terrible. You know, it all seems to really just work. Positioning seems to be good. The pegs seem to be back a little bit far, back just a bit compared to my Transalp. The bars might actually be spread a little farther apart, it seems like. Handles really well though for a little bit heavier bike. I mean, it's not really, really heavy, but heavier than I'm used to, but you can certainly throw it around. See, it goes to where you want it very easily. Braking's fantastic. The front just doesn't dive. You know, the braking with that suspension is just, it's just perfect. Perfect. Sounds really good. The engine reminds me a little bit of the Tiger that I was on it, sound wise. I mean, there's certainly more power, but the sound of it reminds me a little bit of a Tiger that I had demoed last year, I think. And this is just touring mode. I'm not even in sport mode. Not exactly sure what the seat height is for this, but it was very manageable. I was not, my legs weren't stretched at all to touch the bottom, or touch the pavement rather. This thing is just a dream to ride. The suspension is fantastic. I think this is the first bike that I've really ridden that has a premium suspension. And I've never really realized before how a motorcycle suspension should be, because any other bikes that I've ridden, when you're going along and you hit it, you know, you hit a bump and the bike bounces a little bit or whatever, and I've always thought, well, you know, as long as you don't bottom out and the bike doesn't jump around on the road too much, you're doing okay. But on this bike, I'm looking for some bumps and humps to hit, but when you hit them, you don't, not only do you not really bounce or move around, but you don't really feel it. Your butt doesn't really feel it in the seat. You don't even really feel them. It's a different feeling altogether. So I think I just have not really ridden a bike with a premium suspension, so I didn't really know enough to know what I was missing or what I should be feeling. This really been quite an interesting ride, actually. Like I say, I'm almost looking for some bumps and humps to hit, because I've never experienced that on a bike before. That feeling of hitting bumps but not really feeling them. The other thing is the quick shifter on this is the best I've ever used. Better than the Honda ones I've tried, better than Suzuki's that I've used. I don't think I've used any Yamaha quick shifters, but this is much better than either of the Honda or Suzuki quick shifters that I've used before. Yeah, like you hit these little bumps and it's just a completely different experience of moving through bumps with this type of suspension. So I just thought I'd take the bike through town just before I take it back. I just wanted to kind of get a feel for what it would be like in town as well. Very well balanced. Such a well balanced bike. You know, for something that's, I can't remember what it was, I think, you know, somewhere around 520 pounds, I think they are. Really nice. I didn't really play with many of the modes or anything on this ride. I probably should have did a bit more homework before I took the bike out. Robb was kind enough to go through a lot of the modes and stuff with me before I took the bike out, but I'd like to have a bit more knowledge before I start playing with it a bit. But like I said, the electronics packages on these are top notch, and probably arguably second to none. Yeah, nice and balanced bike, and you can just, nice slow turns, easy to do. Love this thing, love it. The other thing I didn't get a chance to test was the adaptive cruise control, another fantastic feature on these. As I said, I know I've said it a few times, but the electronics package on these bikes is second to none. You know, if you're interested in Ducati at all, you know, check these out. And we're back. So if you're interested in Ducati or have questions, be sure to give Robb a call here at Steele Recreation in Bridgewater. He's a very knowledgeable, fantastic guy, and more than willing to help you out.